Hi guys, postman's been. Pretty confident I know what this one is. That's screws. Or bolts, depending on what you like to call them. And this one, I'm pretty sure, is the wheels and tyres I ordered that will fit the MN99SA Land Rover that I've got. But I don't want to use them on that. I want to use them on my rock crawler. So we'll have a look at the screws first. Just check that's what we've got. I can't think of anything else that will make that noise. There we are. Nothing exciting. Just some screws. So, yeah. I needed one or two, and I saw this pack was available, so I thought I'd go for the pack. Right, now for the wheels and tyres. I can feel through the package, that's what they've got to be. What's it say on the back? Okay, it doesn't say my name. Don't give my details, so we can turn it over. Tackle. Okay. There we go. Two sets of wheels and tyres. So I wanted one set for the rock crawler, and I thought I might as well buy a second set while I was at it, because they were on special offer, so I can actually replace the ones on the Land Rover if I need to. Nope. Well, they fell on the floor. Do they look the same? They do look the same. They look like they're genuine replacements. Yep, that looks good. And there's even spare screws attached to the packet. So the next question is, can I fit them on here? With the, oh, dropped that on the floor. Not doing very well today. These are the ones I 3D printed. They won't be, what am I doing? They won't be as strong as these, because these are PLA rather than whatever sort of plastic that is. But they will be just that little bit bigger than the ones that are on there. And we're talking a tiny bit bigger, about maybe a centimetre total in the diameter. I don't specifically need them, but I thought it'd be worth trying them, because otherwise I've got no way of replacing these if they wear out. Right, you might be able to see there is just the slightest difference in size, about 5 millimeters, I would think, in total, in diameter, certainly not 10 millimeters. And why did we have to print the hubs? Because the existing ones, compared to the MN99 ones, the inner flange on the green ones is smaller than the ones for the proper tyres, so they wouldn't fit on the inside edge. And also, the diameter of the stub axle for the MN99 is about a 6 millimetre hexagonal, whereas for this one it's more like 8 millimeters. So that won't fit on the shafts there, and those tires, those ones, won't fit on there. But as I say, these won't be quite as strong. They may well shatter if we go over a drop and they hit the ground. And also, one thing I haven't done, which I intended to do and forgot about, was I haven't drilled the little air hole in it. That one's got an air hole. And that one's got an air hole. Because they're soft, squashy tyres. Oh, come on, focus. Soft, squashy tyres, and you need the air to go in and out. Although, lots of people do actually put foam inside these to reduce the squashiness. So it depends exactly what you need them to do. I guess we ought to go and give that a little try outside.
Okay, first test, curbstone, or whatever we want to call this bit. Okay, did that. How about over there? More of an angle. Yeah, where am I going to go when I go up there? Come back down again, mate. Go that way a bit. Now, I think I've made his wheel track a bit wider than it was, because it used to fit on here nicely. I think I've made those wheels a little bit wider. Oh dear. Yeah, I think I've increased my wheel track there. That was a mistake. Well, it's all right in some cases, but when you've got a narrow log like this, it's also crabbing sideways slightly, so it's out of alignment. Slippery pine needles on there. Bearing in mind these tyres are brand new straight out the package, they haven't worn in at all, so they've probably still got shiny surfaces. Oh, and I've got no brake on this one. Oh, come on. You Seem to be losing a bit of power at the front there. Because bigger wheels would increase the load on the wheel, on the motor. But that front motor seems to be down on power. Yeah, it's doing nothing. If you don't know the story of this, it is a toy grade car that I put hobby grade receiver and the ESCs on. It's still the original motors in it, little 150s or whatever they're called. The only change I've made to them is I've put carbon brushes in them instead of the original brass brushes. Blah, can't say brushes. Yeah, carbon brushes instead of the original brass ones, so they do actually last a bit better. That might be what it is. It might be the brushes are playing up. Oh, come on. I think that'll do. Tires work, they might need a little bit of wearing in to improve their grip, and it looks like I might have a bit of trouble with the motor on the front. Looks like it's losing power a bit.
Hi guys, I just did a video where I showed you I've 3D printed some hubs for my Devil Monster Rock Crawler so that I can replace the old wheels and tires with some new ones. These are actually the ones that go on the MN99SA Land Rover, and although they're almost an identical size, they're actually about 5 millimeters wider diameter than the originals, but the hubs won't fit from the MN99. Anyway, that's all covered in a separate video. I just know that somebody's going to ask, can you put those wheels on my WPL B1 truck? And the answer is no. That's the wheel off of there. This is the MN99SA wheel, which is about, in this case, almost almost 2 centimetres bigger diameter. Certainly more than 1 centimetre bigger diameter. The actual hubs themselves do appear to fit on the hex shaft. So that's good. There's a little bit of flex there, but we could probably get away with it. But it's just where it actually hits the bodywork is the definite problem. And you could probably lift the bodywork up or even take the back of the bodywork off. But then you've got the problem with the steering at the front. That's going to foul as well. So you'd have to lift it all up then, which then makes you top heavy when you're rock crawling. So in summary, although the hubs look like they might actually fit on the axles, the rest of it's too big. So there.
Thanks for watching. If you want more information, check down below in the video description. If you like this video, you might like this one up here. And if you want to subscribe, you can check out my channel over here. Up here is my latest video on my channel, and down here is a video playlist associated with the video you've just watched. Thanks again for watching.